November 18th, 2022. I can't hardly believe it. I can't hardly believe it. Again, this is our annual, this is the second one that we've done. The second annual thankful podcast of the PT Podcast, brought to you by Crossroads Community Church of Lyndale, Texas. I'm your host, PT, with my podcasting partners, the bald beauty, Steve Howard. What's up, Steve?
Hey, how y'all doing?
Hey.
Wow. I thought you still had me muted.
Yes, he has trust issues, folks. He's got trust issues. It's true.
There was some hesitancy there.
Yeah. I tell you, like, you weren't a lion coming out of the cage on that one. No.
Is he ever?
Is this thing on?
I can't hear myself. Are you? Can you hear me?
I can hear you. Can you not hear yourself? You need more?
No, I can hear myself.
Oh, okay. I can fix that.
I was just being a little cynical.
Oh. Are you?
Come here. My OCD's
It's okay. No touchy.
No! All right. I had to fix it. Every time I looked over there, that straight where my eyeballs went, I had to fix it.
I love it. It's on video.
Yeah, it is. It is. That's why we have it on video.
Oh, Lord have mercy. Did you see all that hair?
I've seen man chest. Man,
let me go get the lawnmower. Holy.
I've seen chesticles. Man. That's what I saw. Chesticles. Bless his heart. You need to get that check, buddy.
I need to have a little talk with Lorraine.
There is a
manscaping.
That's the future of forestry right there. I'm just saying.
That's
So, Steve, you're doing good, man.
I'm doing awesome, man.
You had a good time last night.
I did. I had an awesome time last night.
I saw you dancing. I didn't know a white man could dance so well.
I can dance. It doesn't look very good, but I can do it.
The old Pentecostal boy put down the Holy Ghost moves on the dance floor with his wife last night. It was pretty good. It was pretty good.
Yeah. I only didn't step on her toes one time this time.
You're lying.
Okay, once.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I knew you were lying. I could tell by the way she was walking last night outside. I was like, oh, man, poor Lorraine.
Ooh. Yeah.
Ooh. No. Lorraine was like cussing at him. What in the world are you doing?
More asterisks. Get off my foot.
That's an inside joke, by the way, folks.
Bella was on the dance floor yesterday.
Bella?
Oh, fun.
Yeah, my daughter. I've been begging her to come dance with me.
That's because she didn't have a crush on you.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
She still loves me.
She does, but she's not that way. She ain't dancing with you, dude.
Yeah.
No, I wouldn't dance with you either. Not as many times you step on people's feet.
No, I don't step on it all the time.
Yes, you do. Nope. Okay. I believe you.
Just on the waltz thing. You always mess with me up. The waltz.
Yeah.
Are you saying waltz? Waltz?
Waltz.
Lorraine is very patient waltz. While she's dancing, while it's happening and the feet are getting all pressed down. She's like,
Steve?
And that immediately gets down. So anyways, good. I'm glad you're doing. And you look good, man.
Thank you.
I like your shirt.
Thank you. I love this shirt.
Nice and Johnny Cash
very
looking.
Western. Johnny Cash.
Very Johnny Cash looking.
Very
yes.
Young.
Yes. Very the like man in black matches your beard.
Yes, it does.
That's what I mean, most of your beard.
Well, no, he's got the gray and he's got the.
That's true.
I haven't doctored it yet. I need to get.
Do you doctor it really? Yeah, honestly, why in the world would you do that?
Because I don't know.
What? I don't understand.
It's easier to see.
When it's dark?
I don't know.
Well, it's not like it's on your face, Steve.
Maybe I like to be a little younger looking than I am, really. I don't want to look 45.
What are you, 36?
45.
Are you?
Mm-hmm.
I thought he was way younger.
No, he's older than I am. Way older.
Oh, yeah, wow.
I'm older.
Way older.
I may be the oldest one in here, except for I think maybe not.
If we take into consideration, ministry, and the aging that happens in the process of ministry,
you've been through more ministry.
I'm older than all of y'all. Yeah, right? I'm older than every stinking one of you.
Well, that's why we call him Moses.
Is that what you call me? Oh my gosh,
Moses! Come on, Moses!
I'm gonna plant my rod in the middle of your Red Sea. Okay. Yeah.
Oh my God.
Todd the Irishman Burger. What's up, Todd?
Hey, I'm.
You're cooking.
I'm here. Yeah, I'm cooking. I'm making syrup. I'm making jam.
Watermelon syrup. I'm sorry, dude.
I've never had watermelon syrup.
There's a song that's called watermelon syrup, right?
No,
watermelon wine. Sugar.
Watermelon sugar.
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 Hi.
Watermelon sugar. Well,
yeah.
There's the watermelon crawl.
Watermelon sugar.
What in the world is. What is that?
Watermelon sugar. Hi.
Right?
Yeah.
Right?
Isn't that Harry
Styles? Watermelon sugar.
Well, we got all those watermelons.
It's a hairstyle now?
Harry Styles, the singer?
He's a guy that dresses like a girl.
Not all the time. Mm. He is kind of flamboyant. Mm. He's kind of out there.
Is that what we're calling it now? But, the hairstyle is actually...
It's Harry Styles. No,
his like name. I said, his hairstyle is what?
I think his name is Harry Styles.
It is. It's Harry Styles.
Wait, there's a guy's name that's actually Harry Styles.
And he does a song with a man named Marshmallow.
Does his chest look like? Does his chest look like Steve's?
No. That's a Harry style.
It is a Harry style.
It is a Harry style.
He kind of does wear some crazy clothes.
Yeah.
He's like Steve. British, English, no. British.
He's British. He's from British. He's from that One Direction band.
Yeah, he's in One Direction.
No wonder I don't know anything about him.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's as bad as Taylor Swift.
You don't.
Well,
Or Justin Bieber. I like Justin okay now. I mean, it took me a second, but I had to get used to it. At least I know his name now.
Yeah, that's the song he did with that Marshmallow dude, I think.
Which one? Harry?
Watermelon Sugar. Hi. Yeah.
Is that how it goes, really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Watermelon Sugar.
Okay, I'm asking Todd how he's doing. I don't want to know why we got into Harry style.
I don't know either.
What's your hairstyle, dude? It's beautiful. Don't do it.
Farmer.
Don't do it. Oh look at that.
It's
that
farmer is, chic.
Look at that. No,
that's,
got it all. Cut.
That is that. There's all sorts of good looking
he
on
got
that.
Got his
man.
Ears lower.
I'm just saying. Holy cow.
Wow.
No, I see what Kim sees
where,
now.
Where do I get one of those awesome hats like that?
You have to go to...
You have to know somebody.
You have to attend Crossroads Community Church.
Yeah.
I have attended...
No. You have to be a partner of Crossroads Community Church.
I just go in later because I have to attend another church.
You have to be a partner of Crossroads
Community Church. Give up on that other church. Come on over to the dark side.
Believe it or not, there are actually pastors that would agree with you on that. Yes, I think so. So, Todd, you're doing watermelons syrup.
Well, we got all those watermelons out there, and we got all those pumpkins out there. So, yeah, I have a pumpkin in the oven baking. Well, it's done now, but...
Did you bring any?
No, because I haven't made bread yet.
Are you going to make some bread?
Yeah, we're going to make pumpkin bread this weekend and pumpkin pie. Oh,
God bless it.
Right?
Mm. Oh, yeah.
So I know now what your fundraiser should be after... Halloween.
Pumpkin bread.
Pumpkin pie and pumpkin bread.
Yeah. People will come to get that stuff.
I think you could sell pies. I think you could sell pies.
I like so.
And, I like pumpkin bread. Oh, I know too. So, because there are churches in this area that do sell pies and do very, very stinking well.
Yeah.
Really? Oh, yeah.
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 Well, we're going to try a recipe out today, so we're going to see if it works out good. Yeah. And if not, we already know the bread works out good because I've made a few loaves of that.
Well, I'd like to say that I know that it's really good. Unfortunately, every time he says that, no, every time somebody gets some pumpkin bread in my freaking house, it's gone, like in 5 minutes.
Why have I not gotten any pumpkin bread? Because
you don't
either.
Attend Crossroads Community Church.
Again.
Elite.
Steve. Woo! Yeah, where's it at? I'm sorry. I'm not getting the hint.
Come on.
Steve, if you
know, I'm there in spirit.
So yeah, and then I saw a video. It was watermelon syrup. This guy did like a whole deal. He
hairstyle song, right?
No, yeah,
that's watermelon.
It's a hairstyle song.
Yeah, listen to it, folks. If you haven't heard it, go out and listen to it. Download it.
Hairstyle.
He obviously needs the money. So, anyways, I took a whole watermelon and juiced it.
Oh,
and so I guess you can make
rind and all.
No.
Okay,
but you can take the rind and you can make watermelon rind candy.
Oh.
You can make, out of the juice, you can make the syrup. Out of the pulp, you can make two things. You can make jam and fruit leather.
Hmm. I love fruit leather,
I've never
for
had
the record.
Fruit leather.
Y'all want to try that? I will taste
I'm gonna
that
try
for
it,
you. Because I got
the pulp.
What is fruit leather?
It's like fruit jerky.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like dried out, dehydrated.
Mm-hmm. Does it still taste like the watermelon?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, they say it does.
Well, let me put you this way.
I don't want to taste
it
like
came
a rye.
From a watermelon.
But he said it came from the rind or pulp.
No.
Even if the rind tastes like rind, it's still
watermelon. You can
watermelon
candy out of it. So you cut the rind off.
Right? Rind.
Then you take the watermelon, the melon part, okay? The red stuff.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Juice that, okay? Now, watermelon is probably 90% water.
Yeah.
Henceforth why it's called
watermelon.
Melon.
Mm-hmm.
So the melon that's left behind is kind of a pulpy kind of thing, like you would have if you had orange juice, you'd have pulp.
Okay. Yeah.
So anyway, so once you do that, then you take that pulp and you turn it into either jam or
all right.
fruit leather.
Yay!
Win-win.
I'm tracking now. Thank you for
today was Susie Homemaker morning. I had to get that going about 7:30.
He acts like it's such a chore, but the dude loves to cook. He's cooking all the stinking time.
Yeah.
All the time. So, but
I need to start.
And everything you cook is fantastic. I don't know what you guys are scared about.
I need to start everything. Texting Todd.
I haven't tasted anything you haven't tasted.
Yeah.
I haven't tasted.
Come for lunch.
Can I come for lunch?
Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Lunches are usually pretty good.
There's nothing that you've done that I can't even get my hands on the stuff that you've done. The only time I've ever been able to get my hands on something.
You just had my chili the other day.
Well, I know, but that's the only time I can do it.
And my pumpkin bread. I had my pumpkin bread.
All right, I can't do that anymore. We're supposed to be thankful today, and I'm griping
again. I'm grateful that I have not had any yet.
You're thankful that you haven't had any
he
yet?
He says as he rolls his eyes dramatically.
Yeah, it's not as if we can't read your mind on that one,
Steve.
Jeez, golly.
Well, this weekend I'm going to be making large amounts of bread.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so I have a surplus.
Lorraine.
It's good because the church is right now short on bread, so we need it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think it's in the Bible. Give us our daily bread.
That's right. Pumpkin.
Which immediately pumpkin says, forgive us our debts.
Right?
Just need the bread.
Forgive us our debts while we get forgiven of our daily bread. No, that's not what it says. That's not how it goes.
It says.
So you've been busy.
Busy, but I'm thankful.
And you got
I'm
a bunch
very
of pumpkins.
Thankful.
You got a bunch of pumpkins to work with, too.
Yeah.
So you can make.
Now we have sweet potatoes.
Why don't you make pumpkin syrup?
My wife likes sweet potatoes. What?
Pumpkin syrup.
I don't know.
I don't know about that.
Well, you have pumpkin spice everything else. Why can't you pumpkin spice the syrup, dude?
I guess so.
I could try it.
Yeah,
I mean, that'd be good on a pancake.
I bet it'd be good in coffee.
I bet you
the syrup stuff.
You'd be good on a pancake.
Probably, what are you talking? Probably better than that fake stuff.
Pumpkin spice pancakes? Are you kidding me?
You can get those at IHOP right now. just so y'all know.
Well, you can get it at First Watch, and it's a whole lot better.
I'll tell you, I do want to get a one of them freeze dryers because you can take pumpkin and freeze dry the pumpkin, and then you can grind it up into powder.
This may be a hint.
And that right there makes pumpkin flour.
You might want to get.
What can you do with pumpkin flour, folks? You can make a lot of things.
Cool.
I didn't know there was flowers that were pumpkin. Pumpkin flowers.
Pumpkin flour.
They're orange.
Okay.
Yeah.
Big fat.
This podcast has really gone downhill. I feel like we should start over.
Okay, and I'm not even past the introductions yet because I haven't talked to Joe. Oh no, that was a Monica moment.
I didn't get to say anything.
Hold on. What? I've got to cherish this right now. What? I just had a Monica moment.
Monica.
I know.
The you know how she is. Joanna just did the Friends Monica I know thing.
Oh, I want to hear it again.
Yeah, she just did
it. I didn't even realize I did it. I don't know if I could replicate it.
I said, I'm not even past the introductions, and she went, I know.
We can play it back later on because we have it on
Facebook. Actually probably need to isolate that and make it a button.
Make it a button.
Yeah. Yes.
I know.
That would be good. Can you do that?
If I work hard enough to do it. If I actually had a full-time job that was radio podcasting, I'd have a bunch of stuff that was happening on this thing.
Mm-hmm. Steve?
It would be a whole lot better than that one. Yeah, we'd have Steve, and then we'd have and then another thing. So, yeah. All right, so Joanna, what's going on with you, girl?
I'll keep it short and sweet. I'm busy with school, work, kids, books. Kind of happy to be here and take a break from the computer screen for a while.
And mobile Santa.
Mobile Santa is getting geared up, and it takes a lot of work to get that going, and... So,
boy, she's a beast.
She is. It's a lot of prep.
All right.
So
it's not a she. I don't know. Is it a he?
Mobile Santa?
Yeah.
Well, I think he's got a beard. So yeah.
Mobile Santa. Santa is a male. Yeah.
Well, Mobile Santa. I guess but the event mobile... we could name it a her because it is pretty. But I'm just saying. Mm-hmm. And it's keeping us all busy. We're all kind of knee deep in the planning process, but it is absolutely perfect outreach.
Yes.
I love it. And Joanna helps coordinate that thing and get it off the floor so that we can get out to the community and do it. And by the way, that's on December 2nd through the 8th.
Yep.
We're going to be mobile again this year instead of parking or doing any of that kind of stuff. We are absolutely 100%.
We still have our stops.
Yeah, we have all of our stops. We have a bunch of stops.
Yeah.
In fact, we got rid of 3 nights of parking at Crossroads Community Church. We got rid of those 3 nights so that we could be even more mobile in communities. So we added 3 extra nights of being mobile so that we could do so. That was a Joanna thing too. So
good job.
Joanna's
way
doing
to
a
go.
Great job. Administrative skills.
We have over 30 stops.
Wow.
Between Lyndale and Mineola.
Wow.
To fit in a week.
Busy.
Yeah.
Wow.
It is.
Plus
very busy.
The Lyndale Parade.
So 31.
So.
And Cracker Barrel, 32.
So 32. So it's a lot. 32 is not the exact
number.
It is 30 some odd.
We'll be in Mineola on this the 2nd. We will be in the Lyndale Cracker Barrel on the 3rd. And then the parade, the Lyndale City Parade on the 3rd. And then from there, it's Lyndale the whole time through. Lyndale. So, and we wanted to, if we were going to get back to mobility, we wanted to make sure that we were giving Lyndale its credit and its due, because that's where we first started, and we felt like it was time to get back to it. So, COVID, you are no longer ruling any longer.
Amen.
And I know that people are still scared, but I'm just going to tell you right now, Mobile Santa ain't scared. We got Jesus.
We are
done playing that game. So we're going to go out and we're going to have a good time and minister and have fun. So that being said, today we're going to be thankful.
We're going to talk
about things that we are thankful for. I think it'll probably be a very sentimental time. But this is the last season, the last podcast of the third season. And this has been a really...
Second.
Yeah. I'm going to say, surprisingly, this I think has been the best season that we've had. As far as the three seasons that we've been able to put together. I liked the first season. It was great. It was banner. But second season, we got kind of a little short because of all the things that were happening. Mm-hmm. But this season, with the ideas and the conversations that we've been able to have together, I've really enjoyed this season. I thought that it was a very...
We've just been cutting back and having fun. I like it.
Well, and we've had some really poignant topics, too, that we've been able to talk about. So, the addition to you guys being live and being with us and listening and being involved, we're still inviting you guys to call in, and we're going to do the what the heck thing here.
Yeah, somebody call in.
Before we get into the topic, I wanted to make sure and let you guys know that we are extraordinarily thankful for that you guys have given us the opportunity to do this and to be a part of it and keep doing it. We're going to come back in the next year and get on season 4 and have some pretty fun topics. I've already got a couple ideas.
All right.
So we're gonna do that. But let's play the game that you love. And I think this one you guys have liked above all the other ones. We've got several interview decks. One of them is Would You Rather? And the other one is What the Heck? And then there's two interview decks. I think this one is the one that we like the best because it asks us some pretty weird questions. Mm-hmm. So this is What the Heck?
Yeah.
He found a new button.
Brought to you by...
Exploiting it.
Am I exploiting it?
Yeah. Okay.
Brought to you by Mobile Santa.
Brought to you by Mobile Santa. Steve is checking his clock like he's got to be somewhere.
Somebody's calling me. I don't want to talk to him.
Wow. Hope they don't know who you are very well. All right, so that was interesting. That button was okay. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna start with Todd. Pick a card from somebody. Pick somebody.
Any card.
Joanna?
Pick a card.
Joe.
Left hand side.
Joe.
I'm just kidding.
That's all perspective there, Haas.
All right, Todd. If you could bring one famous person back from the dead, who would you pick?
Ooh.
From the dead.
They got to be dead.
Oh, my goodness. Famous person. Does Frankenstein count?
No, he's already alive.
He's pretty famous.
That's a fictional character.
He's already been brought to life.
Fictional character.
Right. Actually, that's Frankenstein's monster.
George Washington.
Really?
Yeah. Yes, I love George Washington. That's a good idea.
Yeah, let's bring him back.
Because he could whoop him up on the...
Hey, it's not your question.
Let's get him back into the presidency.
Be going up there to the White House and just
do
some Jesus.
He'll whoop on some spider shit. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Like,
come on, Steve. Like, Steve.
What?
Steve.
He's right.
It's not your question.
I know, but
he's right. He's right.
That came into my head. Just
it did.
The ghost of Washington going in there and...
Wouldn't that be cool?
That'd be so cool.
Chop it, chop, chop.
How much coffee have you had?
I've had too much, probably.
One cup.
That just came into my head. I thought,
did you bring coffee today?
I had a Jesus Washington moment.
No, there. He did not.
You didn't bring coffee?
He didn't bring coffee.
Turn over tables.
Man, I thought the last podcast I'd have got him.
Okay, so you do realize that George Washington had wooden teeth.
That's all right.
Toothbrushes. I did not know that.
No, well, I don't know, but he had wooden teeth because his teeth, so
rotted away.
I guess so.
They're
all from England.
He was drinking too much watermelon sugar.
I bet you he had a hairstyle.
Yeah.
He had a cool hairstyle.
He got up and put it on every day.
Yeah. All right, Joe, you're up. Pick somebody.
Tim.
Okay.
All right, Tim.
I'm trying to figure out which I got. If you were, why do you always get these? If you were a villain or a criminal mastermind, that was an evil laugh, by the way. Oh my God. There it is. That's the calling card.
Is that the question? What would be your calling card?
Yeah, what would be your calling card? If you were a villain or a criminal mastermind, what would be your calling card?
Probably the same thing as my mascot that we discussed a couple weeks ago.
The foam middle finger. Oh my gosh.
You sure it wouldn't be like raise one eyebrow?
I don't know my calling card. So that would be like the Joker's or the Riddler's little question mark thing. That was his calling card.
He had several. Like he had the
and the Joker had the playing card.
He'd leave a riddle in there.
He had the Riddler did riddles. Mm-hmm. The Joker did like the teeth, like the
chattering.
Yeah. Anything that was clown-esque.
I don't know. Probably a bloody pen. Like
because you're a writer.
Yeah.
That's dark.
A bloody pen.
Where did you get the blood?
Oh my gosh.
Wouldn't you like to know?
Oh my.
I'm a villain, right?
That's right.
She's a villain.
Don't mess with Joanna.
That's right.
I do kill people for a living, kind of. Yeah. So,
Just for the record, she did tell me the other day that she would stab me in the eye with a pen.
She did. Yes. I saw that.
If I do something.
I threatened
to do something for her husband.
You putting that out there so we can have evidence?
I'm just saying, if I come up with one eye missing and she's got a bloody pin.
It wasn't because you tripped over.
But she's not the only one that's thought about it.
A bunch of wood this time.
All right. So I guess it's my turn.
Yep. All right.
I'm going to pick Steve.
All right.
Steve.
What do I want to do?
Steve?
Okie dokie. All right.
I want that one, the one you just picked up.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the one.
Have you ever had a weird Uber experience? An uberly weird experience?
First of all, have you ever had a Uber experience?
No.
I've never done Uber.
No, I have had a taxi experience, but I haven't had an Uber experience.
Let's make it taxi then.
Okay, so we were on our way back. Somebody had died at the church that we were at. Very, very, give me your card, by the way, so we don't repeat.
It's a good idea.
And you have to pick Todd. He's next. So, okay. Somebody had died at the church that we were in. He had a family. Everything got hit by a train.
Oh my gosh.
So we were on a missions trip to Querétaro, Mexico.
Wow.
And we had to fly back. Okay. So that's not we obviously had a taxi at Querétaro, which was, that's an experience in its own self. Mm-hmm. But we get to the storm is keeping us out of Dallas, and so we have to land in Houston, and we don't know how we're going to get back because that's where we ended up. Well, we could have tried to wait for the plane to take us, but there wasn't going to be another one until the next night. We couldn't wait, or the next day, excuse me. We couldn't wait, so we had to get a taxi to take us from Houston Airport all the way to Dallas.
Wow.
Where coincidentally, our luggage was already there. I guess they had flown in advance and that plane was able to land, but we were not going to be able to land. Hmm. So in order to get our luggage, we had to get to Dallas. Our luggage was going to be waiting in Dallas. So we call taxi and it's at some ungodly hour. I think is what, by the time we figured everything out, it was like midnight 30, something like that. Mm-hmm. So we call and the guy that picks us up is in a minivan taxi cab. But I don't know how that thing got to Dallas. We thought it was ratted out, man. It smelled like like cigarette.
Oh, wow.
It smelled like, I mean, cigarette. It smelled like, it was bad. And so me and the pastor, one of the guy, of course, the pastor was in the comfy chair because, you know, he was, I'm not even going to mention the name of the guy, but he's in the comfy chair. And then the other cat was, and I was the young guy. So I'm in the back with all this other, and dude, luggage. I'm just, oh, it was, no, there was some, dude, I don't know. This guy had not cleaned that cab for a second.
Ew.
So it was, yeah, it was an interesting, experience.
Wow.
We made it. I fell asleep. I think
I can't believe you fell asleep.
Oh, I fell asleep, dude. I was so tired. We were wow. all tired. It's a missions trip, man.
I'd be scared to death.
Yeah.
I would have thought if I fall asleep, I might not wake up.
No, I think the other two guys. I was a kid too. I mean, I was maybe, no, I was 20. 20? I was still a kid though. Oh. I mean, I was 20 years old when that 20? Happened. Yeah,
wow. That was just a couple years ago.
Yeah. Oh, I love you so much right now, dude. All right, so go ahead. You got to pick Todd, man.
Todd.
Oh, me?
Steve?
All right. So you look like this kind of guy. This should fit.
Okay, great.
Have you ever been arrested? And if so, for what?
Okay, so I have not been arrested, but I would have been arrested had I not turned myself in. Because
Identify. Oh, my. We're going to hear this
whenever
story.
I was young, like 20-ish, I thought that you got a bill in the mail for your tickets, but you don't. You got to pay those.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't, you get this wonderful thing called a warrant.
Mm-hmm.
Oops.
And so I had a warrant out for my arrest. So luckily, I knew the sheriff. And so I told him what happened. And he said, well, Steve, you got to go turn yourself in.
Hold on. He said,
Steve?
Sounds just like
you got to go turn yourself in. And so I had to go turn myself in and then write a note on there, my name and everything. And I didn't have to go to jail or anything because then I had to go and pay my fine.
Man.
But yeah, I had to kind of.
You criminal.
Yeah, I think
he was pretty young and he didn't know the process.
I may have still had to take my picture. I can't remember if I did.
Same thing happened to me.
Which was his favorite part of the experience, by the way.
Mug shot out there.
There may be. I can't remember if I had to take a picture or not.
Yeah, the same thing happened.
You don't understand. He woke up. He woke up and prepared for 3 hours to take that picture, by the way.
Hold on, I got to shave.
By the way,
he had hair then.
I found out that you do not get a bill in the mail for your tickets. You just got to go pay them.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
It happened to you too, Todd?
Yeah, but I went to jail.
But, okay, so.
And there is a mugshot.
It's all in who you know.
Hold on. How old were you?
22.
Okay, there's a vast stark difference in Steve and Todd, though. Because Todd, I love you, man, but you don't have the ADD thing that Steve has. And so when he walks in and he goes, I didn't know that there wasn't a bill that came in the mail. I'm so sorry. Oh, I can't believe this. And so the sheriff is like, oh, bless his heart, you know. It's like, Todd's like, you imbeciles, you're supposed to send a bill in the mail.
Something like that, yeah.
Book him.
It shows here, Mr. Bergen, that we sent you three attempts.
Oh. Idiot.
Oops.
Well, you sent it to the wrong address. That's what's wrong.
Yeah. Okay, you still reside? No, I haven't lived there for 2 years.
If you don't send me a bill, I'm going to kill you. No, play. I'm joking. All right, so what I'm saying is that the difference between those two things, and sometimes Steve gets off of things. I don't know how he does it. I don't know how, like tickets. He drives as fast as I do.
I do not.
Yeah, yes, he does.
You are so.
Yeah, he does. He does. He drives as fast as I do.
After I got all those tickets, I stopped and started driving like a pawpaw.
You?
Right.
I got them all in my 20s. Mm. And I was like.
Oh. Did you buy a station wagon or something?
No, I was driving I had to drive an hour or so to get to work, and I'd always try to sleep as long as I could and try to make up for it in the speed.
Yeah, how'd that work for you?
Yeah, that doesn't usually work very well. Yep.
After three or four tickets, it didn't work out very well.
He slowed down, but he got a Dodge you know, Challenger. That had a V8 and a 6-speed, and I saw how he slowed down. Yeah. I don't want to hear it, dude.
Slow down.
Some people may
try that car out a couple of times.
Right. Yeah, a couple every time he got in the I'm not going to say anything. All right. So,
You have to do that, or the engine will go bad. It's supposed to be ran like that. It's a sports car.
Okay. So here's the deal. Mm-hmm. We're going to do a round. I'm going to open up the phone lines. It is 903-400-9387. That's 903-400-9387. I have a feeling we're going to have some of the same callers, and I'm totally okay with that. We're going to play a round of what the heck, and you get to choose who gives you the topic.
I got a good one.
I got a good one. Oh, my.
I saved this one.
So go ahead and call. And we will do this thing right. We'll say if you call. If
we're
not,
waiting. Call now.
Call now, please.
Call now. Call now. This is your cue. You can call right now. 903-400-9387. Once again, that's 903-400-9387. And here we go.
Our phone should be ringing off the hook.
Wow, there's so many people that want to do what the heck.
All 92 of you up there on the line better be calling. You ain't got that programmed into your phone yet?
We probably should go ahead and move on just in case they're all scared of this what the heck thing. So,
They're not going to do it?
Well, they may. Oh, caller.
Can't wait to see who this is.
All right. Hold on. Let's make sure you're on the air here. Here we go.
Just start the call or two to decline. The call will start at the beep.
Hi, this is PT. You're on the air.
Hello, it's Lorraine Howard.
Lorraine Howard. It's Mrs. Bald.
She's got a lot of hair, dude.
She would prefer Miss Beauty.
All right, so Lorraine, pick a person, any person.
Well, I'll pick my husband. Be good.
Okay, here we go.
What is the longest you've ever waited in line for something, and what was it?
I'm so glad you finished that.
Oh, okay. So I used to go to the Black Friday ad. And don't do that anymore, but. Oh, yeah. So I remember going with my mom in the morning, and we would stand in line. And I remember this one that was at Kmart, and I just wanted to get a little kitchen stuff that you put for your kids for Christmas.
Okay, yeah. A little kitchen set.
Easy Bake Oven.
Easy Bake Oven. Oh, yeah, I remember that.
That is so worth waiting in line for.
I love those things. I love an Easy Bake. Okay, and that's
but
the
then we had somebody push us down.
That what?
And grabbed the kitchen and took off.
Oh, they threw her down. That's because didn't you live in California then?
Yeah, my mom took her down and got it back.
Yeah.
Go, mama.
Is that Judy?
Yeah, Judy.
How come I can picture that happening? I'm just saying.
That's
just
awesome. Saying.
And I bet you would do the same thing, wouldn't you?
Yes, I would.
That's a good story. Thanks, sir. Yeah. Thanks for calling, Lorraine. That's we love awesome. You, honey.
You're welcome. Love you. Bye-bye.
Love you, Lorraine.
Yeah, that was a good story. That's a really good story. That's a really good story. Okay. All right, so we're going to keep on. Steve has lost his turn.
I have.
So nobody can pick Steve. So, Joe, you're up next. Go ahead.
Todd. Todd. Oh, crap.
Have you ever accidentally texted the wrong person, and how did it turn out?
You didn't do any nudie pictures.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay, no, that is the one thing. We have a rule in our household. No. None of that, because I love my husband, but he is not technologically savvy. Yeah. Somehow it would end up on social media. You know what I'm saying? Yep. There's no rules there. I feel like everybody has accidentally texted the wrong person, but I don't have like some terribly salacious
story. Yes, you do.
You're not telling us the truth.
Do I?
Oh, yeah, you do.
You've texted Tim before something nasty.
Oh, yes.
"Hey, sexy, how you doing? It's great to see you. I can't wait till tonight."
It was so bad. It was so bad. It was so hilarious because it obviously was supposed to go to Donnie.
Uh-huh.
Okay, but it went to me.
Oh, I'm fixing to get told on right now.
Okay. Mm-mm-mm. And so she sends the text message, and me and Cheryl are sitting next to each other, and I go, "Huh?" And she goes, "What?" And I say, look what Joanna just sent me." And she goes, "Oh my gosh, she's texting Donnie." And I go, "I don't think she realizes it yet." And I go, so it was something like, and I forget what you had said, but you had said something like, "Hey, good looking. What are we doing for dinner tonight?" Or something. It was just, and I go, I texted you back. I said, "I'm not sure you're supposed to talk to your pastor this way."
I do remember that. Yeah, okay.
And you, it was like quiet for like 5 or 10 minutes. And Cheryl and I were sitting there waiting for it. And you go, "Oh my God, this is how rumors get started."
That would happen.
So she I guess I was
I texted dirty things to my pastor, y'all.
What are we doing for dinner today?
I'm being nice. I don't remember exactly how it was. I wish I could remember exactly what the text was, but it was years ago.
And I can't believe you didn't keep that. Because now we feel free to text each other horrible things all the time.
Careful.
We know that it, right? You know what I'm saying? We had that relationship, but I'm sure back then, if I was embarrassed about it, then yeah, that was.
You still would have been embarrassed if you would have tried to text. Yeah, yeah.
Oh yeah, y'all don't want to know.
No, I don't want to know.
My hubby.
No, I don't want to know.
Really don't, because he's like a broadcaster. He doesn't mean to be, but
that's what he does.
I can't tell him. You never know at all.
You never know what's going to come out of his mouth.
Yeah, there's well, not a filter. There's not a forethought.
I just see it'd be like this. You'd be like, "Oh, hey, look at this, Chris. Check this out. That's what my wife just sent me." Uh-huh. Chris would be like, "Oh, dang,
Chris is his working partner." Uh-huh. Yeah.
I could just see that. I could.
All right, Todd.
That's another reason we don't send nudie pictures.
Listen, I'm just going to tell you right now. It may be legal in your marriage, but you're not the only one that's looking at those. There's some CIA guy out there.
Somebody is seeing that.
So Joanna picked Todd the Duh. Todd the Duh, it is your turn. You get to pick me or Joe.
You or Joe. I'm going to pick you.
Okay, here it comes. Have you ever had anything waxed? Ooh. If so, what? Waxed or shaved?
Oh. Well... I could tell the story that when I had my heart attack.
Go ahead. That's probably what I was thinking about.
Yeah. As they sit there, and I'm pretty much passed out. I'm laying on this table, and there I hear somebody. They're like, "Hey, we're gonna have to shave his groin." And I'm like, I wake up, and I'm like,
he was unconscious until that very moment.
I was like, "What?" And this little guy, you know, he's like, "Yeah, we're gonna have to shave that." And I'm like. Meanwhile, I'm laying on the table with my pants off, and I'm just and there's a bunch of people, and they got 3 students at the end of the table, and I'm just
watching them shave your.
I'm like, "Oh, this is not going to be good. This is not good."
No. You're telling me that there's like 3 students sitting there watching this happen.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, they were at the end of my table. I look up. I see my wife in the hallway because I can see her through the door. And
she's like,
"I'm like, we got to go. Let's go home. Let's go home. I'm good. They ain't shaving me." Oh, they are. And then, okay, to make matters worse, they did such a horrible job down there. Okay. When I get up to the top where they're going to do the x-rays, there's these 2 guys in there. And they're pretty funny. And the one guy goes, "Wow.
Is that what we're calling it now? Funny.
What happened here?" And I'm like, "What do you mean? What happened? They shaved." And he goes, "No, that's not a very good shave." And the other guy goes, "I'll get it. I'll take care of it." And I'm like, he sounds like he's pretty excited. I know. And the one guy goes, "He loves his job." I'm like, "Oh, gosh." And they shaved everything. Then I was like, "Oh, that's going to itch."
Yep. So, yeah. For sure.
We are in so much trouble. At this point, it's just...
Yeah, we probably should just shut this show off.
No. It's a PT podcast.
How do you go to thankful?
I'm going
to
get...
After this.
Well, you're thankful that you're alive, dude.
I'm thankful I've never had to have that problem.
Yeah.
If I keep eating bacon, I might. I don't know.
Bacon's good for you.
Better stop it. Better stop it.
I don't eat the bacon.
Yes, you do too.
Lorraine says, I'm so glad I picked the card I did. Yeah, you don't want to talk about shaving and waxing.
Why, Lorraine? You want to call and let us in on that? Yeah. Okay, my turn, and I obviously am picking Joe. So go ahead, Joe.
Okay. What slogan or jingle got stuck in your head forever? And I think you should have to sing it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because I know you can.
You know, it's funny. He'll sing it, and then it'll get stuck in his head.
Then it'll get stuck in our heads.
Oh. No, wait. Hold on. Let me take my headphones off.
What's the jingle?
Yeah, what is
it? Man, okay, so there's like three or four, and I know the one that is the call 867-8433 because the next best thing to new is Dilworth Clean. Yeah. That's the one that's in my head.
Okay.
Yeah. But there's another one. It's plop, plop, fizz, fizz. Oh, what a relief it is. Yeah. So, and that one stays in because, well, by golly, I'm a pastor and I need Alka-Seltzer.
I like that one.
Oh, my gosh. So this time of year, with everything that's going on, it's easy to get, what's the word I'm looking for? Not just cynical, but so busy that you forget to give thanks for the little things in life. And you kind of start to overlook things because you're so stinking busy. Yes. Like this right here. What we're about to hear. I'm thankful for this sound right here.
Yes.
And that is not someone taking a tinkle.
No, that is coffee into a pot or into a cup.
That sound like somebody taking a tinkle. Oh,
my gosh.
I mean.
Sorry.
I know that's not what you want.
I know now what that's the one. That's the one.
There you go.
That's the one. So Jesus said something to his disciples one time, says, "How long must I endure you?"
At least till the end of the show.
So the scripture foundation for this week is Ephesians 5. We did this last year. Well, it'll be the way it is every year when we get to this point. But it says, "Look carefully how you walk then, not as unwise, but as wise, making the best use of the time because the days are evil." I don't know if you've noticed outside. Mm-hmm. It's pretty rough out there. So we're going to verse 17 in Ephesians chapter 5. It says, "Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. And don't get drunk with wine, for that's debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with your heart, giving thanks always, and for everything to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, submitting to one another out of reverence for Christ." So wise is addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with your heart. One of the things that I had to do in my life, because there was a moment in my life where music was, I'm still there a little bit, but not as bad because of this scripture reference. I used to think that it was a waste of time for a while. I used to think that church music and things like that was just a distraction, and we just needed to get to the word. And I'm sure that people in their walk at some point get to a place to where they feel like, I'd rather just get to the meat of the word and not worry about it. But you don't understand. There is something about the praise and something about the giving of thanks. And if your heart is to give thanks and not put on a performance, that's why people get cynical, is you get to the place to where you're so busy masking yourself that you don't fixate on the value of giving thanks and praise to the Lord for the little things or for everything is what it says in here. And so don't be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is, that you're not going to get drunk and you're not going to go and sell yourself out in debauchery to other things, but be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord. And if you fixate on that property, you fixate on that foundational concept, then the singing of songs isn't something that we're doing to fill time. It's something that will get our hearts aligned with the right attitude, being wise in giving thanks for not only the great things, but also the things that are hard and difficult, and knowing that those things are producing in us patience and perseverance and all that stuff. So giving thanks is a universal concept that will completely revolutionize the way you think and the way that you address situations. But I'm glad for this scripture reference because it changed my life. When we're talking about giving thanks, and I know there's a lot of stuff to give thanks with, and we'll give ourselves enough time to do that. But we're going to go ahead and start with Todd. Todd, what you got, man, that you're thankful for this year?
This year?
Well, you can name anything.
I mean, obviously, I'm thankful I'm here. I'm thankful that the heart attack didn't take me. But
you man. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm thankful for the farm. I'm thankful for the church, the people that support me, a loving wife, kids. It's definitely been a different year for me. You know, maybe because I'm plugged into a lot more than I feel like I have been. I feel like the years before this, I was plugged into that routine of go to work, come home, go to work, come home, go to work, mm-hmm. come home. Mm-hmm. Periodically, you take a vacation or whatever, but you really mm-hmm. don't appreciate what you mm-hmm. have.
Yeah. Right? Yeah.
Since I don't work, I don't really make a whole bunch of money. We don't.
By the way, you have got to be the most working, non-working person I've yeah. ever seen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Since I don't work.
Who doesn't work.
Who works 24 hours a day. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, obviously the farm.
You're enjoying what you're doing.
Yeah.
So it don't feel like work.
And that's the thing. You know, it's like me and I got a volunteer that's out there right now. He's actually making compost. But he helps out on the farm all the time. And every day we talk about it. And it's one of those things where next thing you know it, 4 hours has gone by and we're like, oh, wow, it's after noon. Wow. Mm-hmm. What the heck?
Mm-hmm.
So you're right. It is something that I am very thankful because I get to do what I love. And this part of my life was something I wanted many years ago. And I just didn't have the opportunity. And so I am totally blessed that God has just given me the opportunity to be able to be here, do this. Mm-hmm. And to provide something for somebody else.
Yes.
You know, it's the giving part, which that's probably the most incredible part, that we're able to help out other people who don't have mm-hmm. or are less fortunate.
Mm-hmm.
We're just starting to ramp up. I mean, we're just getting used to mm-hmm. what we can or can't do on this farm. But as far as growing, oh, man, I think next year it will be leaps and bounds. And, I say, I don't have a job, but you're right. I do have a job.
Mm-hmm. You have a calling. You have a purpose.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Which
fully realizing that though, how revolutionary is that? I mean, from holding a job and going to work mm-hmm. versus realizing mm-hmm. your call and being able to do that. How mm-hmm. cool is that?
That yes. is awesome. That is awesome.
I mean,
yes.
That's where it's at, man.
Mm-hmm.
And you get to do it.
I do.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty.
Wouldn't have happened if we didn't yeah. have a conversation, though.
Well, that's true. But I think mm-hmm. that was a Holy Spirit moment, man.
Oh, yep.
Where we get to
we were heading for Arkansas.
That's right. You were.
It's where we were going.
No, you weren't.
You were. You'll stay right here in East Texas.
We would have latched onto your legs.
It's better here.
Yeah.
Well, I'm thankful. Yeah, I'll get to me later on. But yeah. That is such a cool moment, man.
Yes.
And I've heard other people talk about that stuff. I know what it feels like in my life, but I came around that pretty early on. So to know where you were at in 2018
mm-hmm.
and to see the progression from there to now mm-hmm. and to know the ways that God is coming through in not only y'all's life, but just seeing the fruition, and that's a pastor's dream, is to yeah. walk with people long enough to see, and I've seen it with several, most of y'all in here, being able to see the progression from where, that's what, when the Bible says to lay your Ebenezer, the rock that we lay down to see how far we've come.
Mm-hmm.
And then we look back and it's like, it didn't take very long at all.
No.
For God to just revolutionize mm-hmm. the concept of ministry, not only in my brain, but in your brain.
Yes, sure.
And to mm-hmm. look, I mean, look what's happening, man. I mean, mm-hmm. that's yes. powerful. Cool. That's very cool. That's
and
the way.
And it's great to see all the people that come along, too.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, when you mm-hmm. see, you know, like volunteers, you know, I've had quite a few. And so it's awesome. You know, when you brought your family out and we were picking purple hulls. You know, it's kind of one of those things where you're just like, man, that's so cool.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yeah, I love it.
I do too, man. All right, Steve, You're on, man. Your turn. What are you thankful for, bro?
Well, of course, I'm thankful for everything God's done in my life. I'm really grateful for my wife and my kids, my family. I'm just thankful how he's just leading and guiding, direct us. And we get to do what we love to do, especially Lorraine right now. She gets to do what she loves to do, what she does well, and that's photography. And God has directed us to Winnsboro, where we have a better fit there. It's more of an art community. And we've gotten real good favor with the community. They really like us there. I'm grateful that I've been able to do more of my music, because that's where my heart is in music. It's been fun to get to do more of that and do some gigs here and there. I'm thankful for my parents, who are giving their time.
Some of the most supportive people ever right there.
Man. Yeah, they're giving their time and helping us with the Santa experiences, just like your parents help with your
mobile Santa.
With your mobile Santa. And
they make a really, really
Santas
good.
Santas are expensive. They're like $200 an hour.
Which is one of the reasons why mobile Santa exists, by the way.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's just, and Santa brings joy to kids, and that's what I like about it. It's a great experience for them, and I know that's why y'all love doing it, because it just to see the joy of, you know, of the giving spirit of the Santa. And then I'm just grateful for my friends, for Tim, my best friend. I'm just thankful for where God is bringing us, and he's providing for us. And we get to do what we love to do and see God's provision. Thankful that we have a new foreign exchange student who's just fit really great with our family. Thankful. I'm just very thankful for God and just how he's guided and directed us in our lives. And he's just really blessed. And I'm just thankful for his blessings. And I'm just thankful for who he is and because he's awesome. He's amazing. He's a reason why we get up in the morning.
Now, I can remember back, what, let's see, about 4, 5, 6 years ago?
Yes.
And it was a totally different Steve, I mean, as far as life and what's happening and all the things that were going on. And I mean, I know, like with Todd walking through what I was talking about in 2018 to now and looking back, you know, where you're coming over and we're sharing all the stuff and you're hurting, dude. And
oh yeah, I'm very thankful for Tim being there to help me through a hard time.
But that hard time has led you to one of the most
wonderful woman.
Well, yeah, but I mean, look at the life that you have now versus where you were at 6 years ago.
Yeah, I was a broken man.
It reminds me of that Romans 2 passage, where it talks about, you know, it's don't give up, you know, you're going through the stuff. Yes, you're going through the fire. But and then Romans 8, where it says God works all things together for the good of those that love God and are called according to his purposes. And one of the things I love about the journey and being friends like we're friends is that you're giving praise to the Lord, and I know sometimes it's easy to overlook that, but you've got a family.
Yes,
All 800 kids.
All 800 kids. Yes,
and
I'm very blessed with kids.
You're in ministry.
Yes,
got a great pastor
for our church, church family, and at Church on the Rock as well. I'm grateful that I get to be a part of this church, even though y'all shun me too.
No, we don't shun you. Oh yeah, I notice how much you're shunned. Well, you're on a microphone and a podcaster.
We invite you to everything. Know, you just don't show.
I do too. I show.
Which you're thankful for.
No, I'm grateful for my church family as well, and pastor, and not having the opportunity to lead worship every Sunday as well. And I'm thankful that I get to come here sometimes and see the last part of your sermons.
You know, as if that was the call, but I'm just telling you, man, we it's cool to see where you come from, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And come a long ways.
You're a long ways from that mirror. You're tidy whities.
I know. Yeah. Long ways.
You were tidy whities.
Oh yeah.
No, not anymore.
I wear boxers now. I don't need to know.
They're not white, are they?
Boxer briefs.
I'm just telling you right now.
No, not right now.
You know you are close to someone.
I don't need to know this.
On the bottom bunk, I wake up in the morning time. Can I confirm or deny that that happened, by the way? And so I wake up and I'm drunk. I got to put on my glasses and I see the light of the faucet. Because in our dorm room, when you walked in, that's how long I've known Steve. We were in college together and we were bunkmates. So I walk, you know, you got the door, you walk in and immediately to your right is the faucet and the mirror and stuff like that. And so, and then in the middle of the room, there's a door to go to the shower where the bathroom and the shower is. And it's actually shared by another dorm room.
Yeah.
And so we walk in and I'm sitting there in my bed and I'm just waking up, rubbing my eyes, getting my glasses on. And I wake up and I, you know, get up from the bed a little bit and I see Steve there. And he's not dressed. He's in his tidy whities, okay. He's not sitting there. He just got out of the shower, evidently. Okay,
Good picture to put in your hands.
No, I wake up and I look and I see he's just standing there, and he's turning his head one way, and then he turns his head another way,
and he's looking me alone on.
And he's
someday.
He's looking in the mirror. I'll never forget this. And I go. I wait at least because I'm thinking there's something. Is something wrong? Is there you know? Is there a spider on the mirror? Are we going to have to napalm the? And so I go, Steve, what are you doing, man? He goes, huh?
Making sure one ear is not
the
other.
No. Every so often he'll come up and he'll grab like a piece of hair and he'll switch it over to this. Back when he had hair,
I had a lot of hair.
He had luscious locks back then. Yeah, so. But wow. It took him, yeah. I had no idea what was going on. But from that moment, I now notice that every time there's a mirror, we are in jeopardy of losing Steve for at least 15 to 20 minutes.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah.
Wow. So next season, tune in while I put up a mirror in the podcast room because we're going to have some fun.
It's going to be right behind me. We're going to go, hey, Steve, how are you doing?
Huh?
What? What? Bro.
Actually, you know what? I think I'll put it right
Y'all
there.
Y'all can stop picking on me.
No, we love you, brother. We love you.
I'm thankful y'all are done.
Oh, no. He's got stories he can tell about me, too. He just doesn't do that. So
I don't have them as well.
Oh, yeah. Right. All right, Joe, what's up? What are you thankful for?
Mm. Come on.
Man, I feel like I'm going to repeat a lot of what you guys have said. I'm thankful for...
You're an Arthur. You should be able to...
Arthur.
You're an Arthur. Arthur.
I'm much better on paper.
You're an Arthur. I love it.
I'm thankful for my family, and that looks like a lot of different things. So my church family, my riding family, my family. Family.
See? The blood family.
This is the English coming out in me right there. Yeah. Mastery of the English language.
You can say it in Spanish if you want.
Burrito.
Enchilada.
I wholeheartedly agree with what both of you have said, which is being able to do what you're passionate about and do mm-hmm. what you feel like God has called you to do. Mm-hmm. And I feel like I'm doing that right now more than I ever have in my entire life with leading the youth group and the relationship that we're building with these kids and the changes that I see in them and the time that I mm-hmm. get to spend with them has just been absolutely incredible over the last year. And so those kids are such a blessing to me. Every week it's mm-hmm. crazy, but every week they just bless me. And getting back in the saddle as far as publishing books, getting back out there, meeting people, mm-hmm. that has been, I feel like, a game changer for me this year as far as just reminding myself of the gifts and talents that God has given me and using those and getting to meet with you guys and, mm-hmm. you know,
have fun.
BS for a couple hours every Friday.
Yeah, it's fun. That's right.
You know, it's good. It's laughter. It's good for the soul.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But I'm thankful that I get to work at the schools and the relationships that I have with the teachers and faculty up there. That's cool. And the kids that are up there that are just so so great and getting to build relationships with them. Mm-hmm. So that's been a huge blessing for sure. And I tell you what, we took the youth out this past week to Hope on the Street, and it was such a huge reminder for all of us that we are so amply blessed. We are so lucky to have all the things that we have. And we've been talking in youth about being grateful.
Mm-hmm.
And
that's a good thing.
Being grateful for things, for the good things, and being grateful in the bad things.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just been this wonderful reminder of how we're supposed to renew our mind daily, and mm-hmm. how we're supposed to think about things. And when we feel that negative mm-hmm. entitlement, that greedy spirit come over us, that we have control of our thoughts, and we can take those and we can turn them around, and we can look for the beauty in the ashes. And, mm-hmm. You know, that night that we went to Hope on the Street, we got back in the car, and, you know, one of the girls was going, "Oh my gosh, it's so cold. It's so cold. Turn the heater on." And it was like, "Aren't you glad that we can get in this car and turn the heater on?
Yeah.
Because
for sure.
There's a lady sleeping against a pillar right now that doesn't have that option."
Mm-hmm.
And it was just, I kind of had to hold myself together on the way home, honestly, because I really just felt like I had this deep conviction of, man, you've gotten complacent about all the goodness that's in your life.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm thankful for that conviction. I'm thankful for those reminders mm-hmm. of how very blessed I am, and that there are people out there that don't have those blessings. And it's our job as the church to be the hands and feet of Jesus and to go out there to those people mm-hmm. and minister to them.
Now, there's a reason why you're blessed.
Mm-hmm.
And it isn't not necessarily just to enjoy the blessing.
Mm-hmm.
And the second that Jesus arrives and does what he does in our lives is the second that you are called to a greater purpose with that blessing. And so being able to give that, I genuinely believe that the church is called to be givers in one form mm-hmm. or another. And you have money, or you have, you know, heat, you have air conditioning, you have socks, you have underwear, you have, you know, all these things that at any given moment are at your discretion to bless someone with. And how many times have we missed those opportunities or not even been thankful for those opportunities? And then somebody who doesn't have or doesn't, and it's not because some of them may be totally okay with not having heat and be okay with living on that place and go, "This is where mm-hmm. I belong." Mm-hmm. And we think, well, that's hardship. No, it's not necessarily hardship. Sometimes the best blessing in the world is to not have those things,
mm-hmm.
to not have the wherewithal to get all of that stuff. And so I think sometimes the attitude that the church gets is, you're in hardship. I know that's not what you're saying. You're saying that to look at that and go, we're thankful for what we have, but mm-hmm. we want to share
right.
what is so incredible in us, mm-hmm. you know, the light, the salt, all that stuff mm-hmm. that we're given. And not only that, but the finances or whatever that we can do to bring that hope and healing. And the cool thing that you guys were able to go out and experience that. And anytime, if you think that's cool, I'm just saying the next part of that is the mission trip, where you go out mm-hmm. and you get outside mm-hmm. of your dynamic walls.
So mm-hmm. when are y'all doing a mission trip?
Well, we'll talk about that later.
Oh, I want to be a part of that.
But, it's coming.
Gotta come to church.
Oh.
I don't think so. I want to be a part of that.
Yeah.
And to see, again, when I first met you in 2008. It was 2008. Latter part of 2008. You came to Fade Strange concert in 2008.
Is that?
I came to the Christmas concert. It was the year that Stacy was born. So 2008, she was 4 months old. And
holy cow.
Came to a Christmas concert.
Wow.
And the lady who invited me, they're up there just rocking out. And she goes, yeah, you see the one hammering out the keyboard? I'm like, yeah. She goes, that's our preacher. And I was like, what? I came from a good old Baptist church, man. Uh-huh. I'd never seen a preacher dance. And it was eye-opening. But I went home that night, and I told my husband, I said, I found our church. And it took him a while to get on board, but I'm very thankful that
there's a great story on that one.
I'm very thankful that he did.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So
from there.
14 years old now, so.
From there, I never would have thought. Okay, so from there, she's involved with, you know, she came to church.
Mm-hmm.
She found a church. And then to see what God has seen. Yeah, I get to see from a different perspective.
Mm-hmm.
Because never again are we going to, I found a place, to, mm-hmm. won't you come to a place, to, oh, I'm coming to this church.
Mm-hmm.
To, okay, now let's get involved in Mobile Santa.
Mm-hmm.
Let's, I've seen just.
Growth.
That stuff is what ministry mm-hmm. is about. So my turn. Because
mm-hmm.
there are a lot of things that are coming around to complete fruition. I say complete fruition, full circle. So you have kids, right? Some of you know what this is like because you're a little older than I am. I turn my head to Todd because
I was going to say, why is he looking at you, Todd?
Because I'd be the oldest one in the room.
So my youngest is getting married December 18th, and I have been able to see. My kids and my wife and everybody else kind of in this process, looking at the full circle thing of you've watched them, they're born, they grow, they get to a place to where they think you're the best thing ever.
Mm-hmm.
And then they get to the place to where they think you're the worst thing ever.
Mm-hmm.
And that you don't know anything. And then we've experienced, it's good night. We've had great, incredible highs all along that process. We've mm-hmm. had really, really terrible lows.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like, really some tragic stuff yeah. that's happened. Very We've tragic. All walked through that stuff.
Yes.
Some of the... I think that's what I'm thankful for this year, I'm going to say that, the most, is all of it. I'm thankful for that process, because now when you're looking back and you're going, okay, that's where it comes around where you're going, okay, we went through all of that. Mm-hmm. We walked through all of that stuff to now I'm looking and going, oh my, this is my kid's about to be really, really blessed with one of the, such a great lady. I mean, she's mm-hmm. amazingly wonderful. And there's nobody perfect in this world as far as nobody is completely Jesus as far yet. I think mm-hmm. we'll get there someday when we're fully conformed to the image of Jesus Christ when we're there. But
yeah.
as far as for my son, those two, they're that's just, and nobody could have done that but Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Not with everything that's happened, not with all the stuff that's gone on, and not mm-hmm. with all the history and with all the mistakes that I made, or because Cheryl's been perfect. But as far But to see the progression from point A, birth, with mm-hmm. galactosemia, not able to have lactose or anything like that, and we're scared for his life all the time. We're scared that he's going to be allergic to this, and real cautious about this baby kid with the big ears. To going through all of this life to now, we're less than a month away from him getting married.
Mm-hmm.
And to a wonderful lady, and he loves Jesus.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Mm-hmm. It's awesome.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm. Something to be grateful for sure.
Full heart.
Amen. Yeah. Yes. Amen. It's awesome.
Stupid music.
It just makes you cry.
It makes you want to cry.
So yeah, man. I mean, some of you are at home and you're worried about the process.
Don't.
I'm surrounded. By testimony.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It'll happen.
Mm-hmm.
It'll happen.
It's pretty awesome. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Man.
Yeah. So don't get lost in the process of the journey, because yes, there are difficult moments.
Mm-hmm.
But man, I could tell you stories just from here.
Mm-hmm.
That if you don't give up and you keep trekking and you learn then there will be some amazing moments mm-hmm. that you can yes. look back and go, holy cow, look how far God's brought me.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
Look at what God yes. is doing. And so yes. do you get low? Yeah. Do you get a little upset over things? Yeah. Do you get tired of battling? Sure. That's why Paul always said, don't grow weary in well-doing. Don't lose heart when you're trying to take mm-hmm. heart, stand when everything you've done and you've taken mm-hmm. everything you could do to stand and put on the full armor of God, which has no back armor, by the way. He's your hind guard. But the fact of the matter is that some of you have been really close to giving up. Some of you are really close now mm-hmm. to saying, I don't know what the next turn is and I have no idea. But I'm just telling you, I've got a Todd in the room who was there three years ago. I don't know how this is going to work out. I don't know where we're going. And I've seen Todd not give up. He's been close. He's mm-hmm. made mistakes along the way. He'll say it. He's shaking his head. Yeah. Oh, yeah. And then I see Todd where he's at now. And is everything, you know, hunky dory? No, but the process is, I mean, he's a minister and mm-hmm. he's loving the Lord with the calling and it's massive compared to where you were three years ago, dude.
Oh yeah.
Then I see Steve, who, man, was at a point of not wanting to be here anymore. I mean, literally. And now he's made a difference in Ian and Bella and Bryce and Cody mm-hmm. and these kids that have come along that didn't know a loving. I mean, it's pretty rad, dude.
Yeah,
and
pretty blessed.
And to be at a church where you're fulfilling the calling of God in your life yes. that you've been wanting to for the longest time, and now starting to go frontline ministry like other people, where you're singing love songs, but you're mm-hmm. you're loving people in the process.
Oh yeah, I sing some Christian songs in there. Some songs I wrote. Some they love it.
But 6 years ago, dude.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you didn't think you would get out of that. And now you're...
I know.
Now you're married to a wonderful woman.
Yes, very blessed.
That loves you, thinks the moon rises and sets in your pants, dude. I'm just saying, that's... She's going to agree right now.
In your eyes?
Yeah. In my eyes.
Okay. In my eyes.
I'm waiting for that ticker
it's
to move.
In my eyes.
She's going to be like, I'm turning this off now.
In my eyes.
No, while everybody else is tuning in. All right. So, and then Joanna, just being able to walk with her for 14 years and her family for 14 years and mm-hmm. seeing tragedy mm-hmm. and then seeing, I mean, good grief.
Mm-hmm.
You couldn't ask for... I'm thankful for your testimonies, guys.
Yes.
Because this is how we overcome.
Grateful. Amen.
And being able to see that from the grateful. From the top down. Yep. So.
Yes.
Enjoy the process. Yes. That's what I'm saying.
That's right.
Yeah. Yep. Anything you guys want to add?
No, I think the part about not giving up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's a good emphasize one. On that. Because really, people who... Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Tomorrow needs
Jesus. Coincidentally, that would be my next... The semicolon.
Yeah,
Will be the next tattoo that I get because of what it signifies. You can read the back of this thing and it'll tell you.
Oh, gotcha.
Read it
out loud, Todd.
Read it, Todd. I can't read it.
A semicolon is used when a sentence could have been ended but wasn't. Your story isn't over.
Nice. Cool.
Yeah. So I think that everybody
get that tattooed at.
I don't think it's probably going to be either on. It'll be on this arm, but it'll be either
left butt cheek.
Probably.
That's what I was going to say.
It's going to be right at the crack.
Old video snapper.
Where a sentence could have ended.
Butt and end.
Because you know, butt
and end.
Yeah.
And the last thing I want to say that I'm thankful for before we get out of here. Yes, the semicolon. You're saying that people could stay and they need to keep going.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Don't give
keep
up.
Keep going.
Keep going.
Yes.
But the thankful thing I want to say is I'm really thankful for the opportunities that we are all getting at this point to mm-hmm. to disciple and to be a difference maker in the process. And that calling that you guys have all accepted, everyone at this table, mm-hmm. and everybody at home needs to accept that too, because yes. you're not called to be mm-hmm. a pew warmer or a bench sitter or a sitting on your pious gas bag. You are called to get up and make a difference. If you have Jesus... There's no reason for you to give up. There's plenty of light, and he loves you and wants you to keep going, and that's what Todd and everybody else here is saying. Yes. Is that, and yes, the journey sucks sometimes, but the fact of the matter is that at the end of it, when you walk through it and wade through it, you're going to find yourself in a better position.
Turn your tests into testimonies.
That's true.
Who said that?
Joanna.
Joanna said that?
No, I did not. I stole that. Yeah. In fact, I think you said it one time. I stole it from
I don't know
you.
Where I got it.
I might have actually known that, I've which is why that. I asked her. She said
No, I totally stole that, but it was great because we were talking about that at youth. Mm-hmm. You know, how to be thankful in the bad, not for the bad. But in the bad.
Yeah, you don't need thankful for it.
You know, being able to look back and see all the things that God has brought you to or through.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then, okay, if God brought me through this and this and this, then whatever I'm walking through right now, he'll bring me through that too.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And having that faith and that perseverance to know I've got Dad walking in front of me. I'm going to be okay.
Mm-hmm. And you've got, I mean, all of us. Mm-hmm. We're arm in arm with some of the greatest people in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Yeah. I'm just saying. I've never been surrounded with greater people than what I am right now.
Agreed.
Yes. I found my crew.
Yes.
This is my people. I love, and some of you tick me off.
Mm-hmm. You're welcome.
On a daily basis. Okay, so we had somebody call. I may or may not have been talking about him, so I'm going to call him back and see if I put him on the spot here, and see if we can. See if he answers, first of all. He might be in the bathroom.
Jesus, are you there?
What?
Hey.
Yeah.
Did you call?
What's up? I did, but I didn't know if I was supposed to call or text because I keep joining in too late.
Oh, you're good, man. What's up, man? This is Grayson, by the way. This is my
you are on the air.
This is my son, and he is on the air. This is Grayson Letch, my youngest son, who is about to get married and become Mr. Grayson Haskett.
You want to try that sentence over again?
Yeah, that works.
Yeah,
Grayson Haskett.
So what's up, man? What do you want to say?
One family and going to the next. I guess.
What did you want to say, Bubba?
I was just saying that I'm thankful for family.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Family is the greatest out of everything.
Yeah.
And family doesn't have to just be people with the same last name as you.
That's right. You happen to have a fabulous auntie who loves you very much, but is not blood related.
Who's this?
Just saying.
Who?
Oh, Steve.
There was a mirror somewhere. I know it. I just know it.
Hey, Steve, you got a beard here.
Yeah.
Other side. Other side.
Hold on. Oh, my gosh. Oh, he's got the camera phone.
Oh, no. Oh, we've lost him. It's over.
He's gone.
Yeah, you're right, man. Family is not just blood. And you've learned that over the years from being around us, that family is a lot of different names in a lot of different places. So.
Yep.
And that's what you wanted to call about, is just say that you were really thankful for family, huh?
Yeah, I mean, your family, you're like blood family, but I also have people like Steve in my life and Todd in my life. So
cool.
They're both great men in my life that make me happy.
Awesome.
And then I have Joanna, who I've known for my whole life, pretty much.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And
well, she's always been there. So
sweet.
If I wanted to play a joke on Mom or play a joke on pretty much anybody, Joanna would want to know. So.
And help out.
Yeah, it helps.
That's supposed to be our secret.
So now I know if Joanna calls and says something that's, you know, terrifying about something, I'm like, yeah, okay. You guys are full of corn.
It's just me and Grayson teaming up again.
That's funny.
Well,
I think it's great that he's
more so in the youth days.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Well, I love you, buddy. We're proud of you.
I love you too. That's all I
know.
Love you.
Thanks for calling, man.
Bye.
Yeah. And listen, I mean, my whole family with Cheryl, you know, going through what she's gone through as far as the schooling and Gabriel going through what he's going through and the job and everything that he's been able to hold down for. It's been a great year. It's been a banner year. So for those of you at home and everybody that is on live with Facebook, and we just want to tell you guys, we're thankful for you too. Thankful for the opportunity to do this with you every week. And this is the last podcast of the year, but we love you.
Yes.
We are so blessed to be able to do this. And we hope that you have a safe, wonderful holiday season.
Yes.
Enjoy your family. Every second of every moment with your family. This song that we're about to play is going to be
a song in a long time.
Is that your song?
We haven't. But this is the new release from the Tim and the Tim Schlesner.
Tim.
Yeah, Tim Schlesner is a co-writer with me.
Mm-hmm.
And we have co-written a song that is called The Empty Chair.
All right.
So Steve is like really excited about this.
Yes.
It's very what's the word I'm looking for? Sad.
Yes.
So if you have an aversion to sad songs and you don't want to cry, the reason why I say cherish every moment is because what ends up happening is people, we get to a place to where we look over and take things for granted. And sometimes the person that was in that chair last year may not be in that chair. So take the time to be thankful. Take the time to enjoy the moment with them, because at the end of the day, you're going to want to have that time with them back. When the moments for granted. So I say that knowing full well that I've got grandparents and people that are in my life at this moment that sometimes I take for granted. And I want you guys to be thankful and make sure and give them ample time this year. Just give them a big old hug and just soak in every stinking moment that you can, because they're precious. This one's called Empty Chair. This is not released yet to the public. You can pre-order this song anywhere.
When is it going to be released? Because I want
Thanksgiving at 11 p.m.
Thanksgiving at 11 p.m. Okay.
So and it'll be released to the public. You can get it then. 11. I think it has sentimental value with Tim.
Okay.
Yeah. Tim Schlesner. I think that's when he put it down, and I'm cool with whatever he decides, since he's pretty much the guy that coined this out. And he, by the way, is the label owner, Highway 69 Music. He is a label owner as well, and in charge of doing all this stuff. So he's a great writer. I was proud to be on this. This is the lyrics written by me and Tim Schlesner, and music written by me. And we're going to listen to this song. It's called Empty Chair. If I can get it to work, let's see if we can get it to work.
Come on, work.
Here it comes.
Oh yeah, let's try to get out the music here. Here, let's try that again. Let's try that again. That way, we know that we can have this playing for you guys. Here we go. This is for real now. This is live. This isn't Memorex. This is Empty Chair by us. Here we go.
Ties that bind us to, right now they're just scattered, these memories of you. We've all got our favorite moments, but it's hard for us to share. How I wish for one more Christmas to see you in that chair. There's an empty chair at the table, missing presents round the tree. And every moment here without you feels like it shouldn't be. In my dreams I still see your face, and feel the joy that always be. When you were sitting here each Christmas in that empty chair with me. I feel your laughter in my children. I see your love inside their eyes. And every second that I'm with them, it makes me realize that these holidays are precious, and I'll cherish them with glee. 'Cause it won't be long before that chair might be missing me. There's an empty chair at the table, missing presents round the tree. every moment here without you feels like it shouldn't be. In my dreams I still see your face and feel the joy that always be when you were sitting here each Christmas in that empty chair with me. Oh, so hang the stockings, deck the halls and light the tree, and when we celebrate this Christmas it'll be with family. But I know there'll be a moment when I look to find you there, and all I see when I glance that way will be an empty chair. There's an empty chair. And every moment here without you feels like it shouldn't be. In my dreams I still see your face and feel the joy that always be when you were sitting here each Christmas. When you were sitting here each Christmas in that empty chair with me.
Beautiful.
And that was Empty Chair.
Very pretty.
Mm-hmm. Just reminding you guys, get all the time you can in with all those people in your life, because it's for sure. There's a lot of people out there right now that are going through that where they're missing their people. So that was Empty Chair, and that's the much anticipated arrival, because I know there are a lot of people that Steve has been chomping at the bit, begging to get that. So you guys go out and grab that, and on Thursday, next Thursday, we'll have that released to you guys. Otherwise, anything else? Anybody on there that are saying anything that need to be shared? Or
Grayson says it's actually a beautiful song, priceless, worth every second of work put into it.
Oh, that's very true. There's a big story about that, by the way. So I came down with a pretty bad upper respiratory infection in June. Mm-hmm. I very rarely do I ever miss church service. I mean, it's doesn't usually happen. And I went in to the studio that Friday to record two songs, and I was only going to do a scratch track for Empty Chair, and I was going to finish the Everything mm-hmm. I Ever Wanted. That mm-hmm. was the last song that we released, and I didn't think it was going to be. In fact, it took me a good 10 takes of Everything I Ever Wanted to actually sing that song and sound like I wasn't croaking every time I did something. So we had to take it in sections because I was really in bad shape. So Empty Chair comes around and they go, well, We've got the piano and we've got all the other tracks to it. Do you want to try to lay a scratch track so that we have something? So what you're hearing on that track is the first take of Empty Chair. One take, one pass. That's it. That's all it took. Beautiful. Voice. Awesome. I don't know what happened or how it happened. I think a lot of pitch correction is what I think happened. a lot of it. So, but that was a
whatever.
It's a cool man. It's so cool to like we're talking about the journey thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. To know where that song started. You were here when I went. Yep. Oh, I think I got this. A great song. And so it's came in. Then it come to this point. It was mm-hmm. like holy cow. When we first heard it, we were freaking out about how fun it was to see where it came from. So, all right, guys, have a great holiday season. Yes. We're not going to be able to talk to you guys until January, but we'll be back in black.
You want me to wear black?
No, just a statement. No, you don't have to wear.
I got my black hat.
Steve's wearing his black underwear. All right, so
and a shirt, black shirt.
Yeah, he's the man in black.
I'm the man in black.
He's the man in black. If guys, if no one has told you, God loves you, so do I. And we hope you guys have a great holiday season. And until we see each other next year.
This is Todd Bergen.
This is Steve Howard. This is
Joanna Grace.
This is PT. We love you guys. We'll see you next year. Good night. God bless you. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye. Turn up.